Happy Friday, guys. Today's home workout is for time. 15 thrusters, then 45 bar facing burpees, 12, 36, 9, and then 18. So descending in reps, thruster weight today is meant to be heavy. So if you can find something a little bit heavier than usual that you use for thrusters, I'd recommend that for this workout. And then bar facing burpees, if you don't have a bar, maybe find just like an object that you can jump over that's about 10 to 12 inches off the floor, and use that as your bar facing burpee height to jump over. The main focus of this would be the thrusters, guys. Try to find that heavy weight, and the 15s should be a weight where you're doing it in about three sets there, so three sets of five. Same idea when you go to the 12s there, you're doing it in sets of fours and then sets of threes. That's kind of a guideline I would choose for those thrusters. For the burpees there, guys, that's kind of the cardio component of this one. So we're doing a strength endurance style workout. You're gonna be working on the strength of the thruster and then building that endurance with your bar facing burpees. And as you come back to the thrusters, try to really find that tension in your body, get yourself nice and set before you pick up that weight for your thrusters today. Again, if you don't necessarily have something heavy, maybe you can get two lighter weights and double it up. So if you usually use one kettlebell, if you have two kettlebells, use that. Or if you usually use one object, if you can grab two of them this time to make it just a little bit heavier, try that for the thrusters. I totally recommend you guys do that to get the proper stimulus out of this workout. Once you guys finish this workout, we're gonna finish off with a hamstring stretch. We're gonna go about 2 minutes per side. If you have a certain stretch that you usually do, you guys can go with that. I'm gonna show you some recommendations later on. But make sure you get after that one, guys, especially with the thrusters. Those legs are gonna be fired up. Those hips flexors are gonna be fired up as well. And they're gonna slowly start to get tight. So with that hamstring stretch, you can kind of start to release those areas, helps open up those hips as well. Especially I find once those hamstrings get really tight, my lower back tends to get more of the load when I'm doing a workout like deadlifts or anything like that. So we really want to try to stretch them out and be able to kind of get into those positions for future workouts. So make sure you get after that stretch after the workout there. And one thing I forgot to mention with the workout, it's a 14-minute time limit that I put for the class. So try to aim somewhere between that 14-15 minute range to finish this workout. Again, if you don't have the weights, you might be finishing a little bit earlier, maybe around that 10 to 12 minute mark. Hope you guys enjoy the workout and the afterburner. We'll see you next for the warm-up video. All right, so for today's warm-up, guys, we have the 60, 45, 30, and 15 seconds of Russian twists, alternating gorilla rows, and kettlebell swings. So as we go down in those intervals, I want you to increase your intensity, go a little bit faster to increase that heart rate. First movement, Russian twist, guys. You can use a weight or you can just go body weight, whichever one you feel comfortable with. Let's keep our legs off the ground, tightening up that core. Hands can be linked together. We're gonna reach over to the opposite side each time, really trying to twist at the trunk as we do that. Make sure you're not reaching for it. I like to link my hands together and really try to keep them straight as I do them. Then that really pushes me to twist my trunk as I do that Russian twist. Next movement, guys, for 60 seconds, we're gonna go for alternating gorilla rows. So find two objects that you feel comfortable going for single arm rows or those alternating gorilla rows for 60 seconds here. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go into that wide stance, kind of that sumo stance, bend over at the hips so that the weights are between your legs. And then from here, guys, we're gonna pull one arm up, shoulder back nice and tight, really feeling that lat. Then we're gonna alternate with the opposite. We're gonna go for 60 seconds of as many reps as we can in that 60 second interval, guys. Next movement after that, use one of your weights and we'll go for kettlebell swings. So squat stance here, back and chest up nice and tall, hinge at the hips, drive that weight straight overhead. As you do those kettlebell swings, guys, really think about your breathing, start to link that up with your movements. And again, use it as a cardio movement to get your heart rate up during this warm-up. Next interval, you're gonna do those three movements again, 45 seconds, then 30, then 15 seconds. And increase your intensity as you go down, guys, in those time periods. After you're done that first part of the warm-up, guys, we're gonna do some quick mobility for that front rack position. So find a post, or even if you have a door frame, you can use that as well. We're gonna get our elbow, so this meaty part of the tricep, onto the post like this, and then we're going to push our body, so this part of the body here, guys, so that lat where it connects all the way up to the arm. I want you to get it close to that post, holding that for 60 seconds. You should feel a stretch in that tricep, in that lat as well. You might feel in the back of the shoulder a little bit, but we're gonna go for that 60 seconds, play around with it. You don't have to stay static. As you're in that position, you can also try to move your hand out to the side a little bit, twist, externally rotate, internally rotate, play around with it, really try to get a good stretch out of that front rack. That will be the warm-up for today, guys. We'll see you next for the movement standards. Try to use just one object for those thrusters. So we're gonna hold that in the front rack position. We're gonna come down, again, nice and controlled, just like that sumo deadlift. Coming down with control on the way up. Be explosive with the hips and drive that object straight overhead. Make sure, again, with that squat on the way down, we're staying tall with those elbows, making sure they don't drop at the bottom. Where do you position your rope for your burpees? Then from there, you're gonna go into your burpees. So 3 to 5 burpees, finding that rhythm of what the speed is gonna be. Are you stepping into it? Are you jumping up for it? Play around with it. What works for you, okay?
Okay, I got my gambling pose here. Getting ready for this stretch we're about to do, guys. Going for a 2-minute hamstring stretch. First option we're gonna give you here is just reaching for your hand or your foot with your hand. So as you reach forward, your leg is locked out, so at the knee, it's locked out. You are gonna round your back a little bit here. That's fine, but you're trying to feel that in that hamstring. So as you're holding it in the 2-minute, for the 2 minutes, try to dig a little bit deeper by either reaching over your foot a little more, or as you're actually doing, kind of wiggling side to side. To feel different areas of that hamstring. Breathe through it as you let go of your breath. Try to see if you can sink down a little bit deeper. Again, 2 minutes, you got time to play with it, so play with it. So this is your first stretch. Second stretch here is take a belt, take a skipping rope, take a band, it's available to you. Take it over and wrap it around your arch of your foot. You can pull your heel up towards you, keeping that leg straight. You can then start getting into your inner hamstring by dropping to the inside. If you don't feel much of a stretch, play around with it by maybe bending your knee, or you can even externally rotate at the hip, maybe internally rotate. Okay, bottom line, you're playing with it for the 2 minutes while you're down there, guys. So see what feels tight for you, play with it. Then when you're done the 2 minutes, you're gonna switch to the other side. So we're going for 4 minutes of mobility flexibility today, specifically for the hamstring, whether it's the inner hamstring or not, guys, you find which area feels a little tight. And we'll see you tomorrow for the workout.